Drink Spring. I'm your host, Avon Price, and I'm here with the Sales and Information Director, David Taylor. I was about to say Taylor David. But, you know, we were talking about comic books, so now we got to be serious. So you're here to give us updates about what's going on in your department, what are the latest numbers, and all that kind of stuff. Can you kind of let us know?
Yeah, well, you know, once again, thanks for having me on the show. I always like to come here and give updates to our residents.
You know, so we're in the third month of the year. Kind of crazy how fast time flies when you're having fun. But, you know, we closed February. You know, we had 14 more residents join us here at Green Spring, which was great. You know, we're tracking right now, you know, we have 22 move-ins to start the year, which is incredible. I mean, we're trying to get, once again, to kind of that, you know, we'll probably end the year somewhere around 150, 154 moves. So to have 22 folks kind of enjoying the lifestyle already in to the second, third month of the year is pretty incredible. It keeps us pretty busy. So
now, since it is still kind of the beginning of the year, would you say for your department is the beginning of the year kind of like your most important, kind of wanting to start off the year right, or is it more towards later in the year?
Wow, that's a great question. You know, I think the beginning of the year we always want to make sure, you know, we start on a good fit, so we're not kind of chasing ourselves. And really what it comes down to is, you know, making sure that we have folks moving in so that our occupancy stays at a good rate, so that everyone can enjoy, you know, cost staying where they are. And we always like to make sure that we're trying to get folks in earlier rather than later. Typically, you know, as we get into kind of more the end of the year, the November, December, not many people want to move during the holiday season, during the winter. So we really want to maximize the fact that spring is here. It's a great time to move. And we want to get ahead of those moves so that we're not trying to get folks to move in towards the end of the year. So, yeah, I would say this is probably the most key time. I would say probably this, the first 3 months and kind of the middle part of the year are probably when we're trying to be the most busiest with bringing folks into the community.
All right. So talking about moves, we were talking earlier that you wanted to make an announcement about your department and some moving going on in there. Can you want to discuss that?
So yeah, absolutely. We just wanted to let all the residents know that, you know, we're going to have some changes happening in our office space. We're actually changing the design of our space in the sense that we aren't going to have anyone sitting up front anymore.
Really?
Everyone's going to be moved to the back. We really want to create a nice atmosphere for folks when they come and visit with us. We want to have more seating for our guests. It's really hard to, if we're having two or three appointments at a time while they're waiting for who they're going to meet with, it's really hard for them to kind of find space in our front lobby. And so we want to make sure we have a great experience. So just for residents, as you come by and you're stopping to see us, if you just check in with the front desk and let us know that you're out there, if you need to see us or pay off something, or you have, you know, a brochure you want to pick up, because we just want to make sure that all of our customers and our residents are greeted by someone. So if you just use the front desk as kind of a, hey, we need to talk with sales, we'll make sure that we get up there. But don't be alarmed if you don't see anyone up front.
So if I'm understanding things right, not only is there a move, but there's going to be a change in kind of the procedure.
Correct.
In getting in touch with one of you or, you know, your staff members to let the front desk know, hey, Avon's here, he's trying to pay his bills, or not pay his bills, but, you know, wants to speak to the sales office instead of just walking in and seeing someone.
Right. If you walk in, once again, you can always walk in, but we just want to make sure that they're aware, or that residents are aware, that if you walk in, don't be alarmed that there's no one there. Mm-hmm. We may all be in appointments. That's the other thing. So we don't want our residents to just be standing in the front lobby and us not knowing that anyone's out there because we're in appointment. So if we can just utilize the front desk associates, that would be great. And then they can let us know that you're out there.
So what kind of, I guess, structural changes to the office? Is your conference room going to get kind of cut in half
down? That's a great question. So we're going to have a couple of associates move into the conference area. You know, we're going to move around who's going to be sitting where in cubes and in offices. And then, like I said, we're going to be making some tweaks. We're going to be offering beverages, some different seating. And it'll also give us the ability, with all this repositioning and life cycle construction going on, it'll allow us to put display boards up and to kind of show videos on kind of what's to come at Green Spring, which I think is key for anyone moving into our community. We want to let them know about all the great changes that are happening here as well.
So I like this. This sounds like a real, you know, nice move and everything.
Yeah, it'll be fun.
So well, I got something real important to ask.
Yeah.
will you still have chocolate out?
We will still have chocolate out. We'll probably be introducing some other new treats, some select different types of coffee, some more gourmet coffees. Mm-hmm. We'll probably bring cookies back.
I know you used to have cookies out. I would drop by and, you know, take a cookie or four.
Now, they are for our prospects and residents, Avon.
I'm a prospect. I'm just jumping ahead of time.
That's right.
So, that's great to hear. So you mentioned repositioning.
Yeah.
Now, I would think, you know, just looking as someone who's not in the marketing department, that the construction would be kind of off-putting for residents, you know, potential residents coming in.
Yeah.
Now, how is this repositioning happening in Village Square and Town Center going to affect the marketing department?
You know, that's a question we get actually quite a bit. And what I always tell folks is, from the sales and marketing standpoint, we actually love seeing construction and repositioning. It just shows that Greenspring as a community really values the services, the amenity spaces that we have in our communities, and we're willing to take that extra mile, take that jump to make sure that they're the best we can offer. Mm-hmm. And so whenever we see construction, we really frame it as this is progress. This is a good change. Mm-hmm. It's better than seeing kind of some outdated spaces. It's really great to see kind of these fresh, new places come online, and it's actually really exciting for the sales team. Mm-hmm. Because we can get out there. That's one of the reasons why we're going to have display boards in the new lobby that we're going to have in our office. It really just shows excitement, and it's almost kind of gives you that, hey, get in now, because Town Center, Village Square, these are going to be places people are going to want to be around. Mm-hmm. So get in now before, you know, we sell out of all those areas. So we're really excited.
Okay.
I think it's been a long time coming. I think the residents and our future residents really enjoy a lot of these new spaces that we're bringing, and I know it's going to be an inconvenience. You know, mm-hmm. it's going to be an inconvenience for us to show, and there are still going to be some people who say, you know what, we're going to wait until that construction's over. But I think mm-hmm. the majority of folks that are coming to visit us really want to see that we are just as updated as some of our competitors in the area, and all of this repositioning and the life cycle construction mm-hmm. work is showing that we're taking the extra steps to do just that.
Okay, and so how are things going with like the different apartments? Are you what kind of open apartments do you have now?
So we have a handful of apartments open right now. You know, once again, we're always trying to get down to single digits or get down to very limited inventory, and we're working on it. You know, we have, I want to say as of today, we have about 15 or so apartments right now, which is a great place to be. If you think about, and I said this the last time I was here, you know, you think mm-hmm. about where we were in November and September of last year, having almost 40 apartments, you know, really to be in the teens is a great place to be. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm always trying to strive and helping the team really understand, hey, let's get down to single digits. Let's get down to minimal inventory, because that's where you really see the benefit of our occupancy. Mm-hmm. You know, being at 98.2 as today is a great place to be.
Yeah.
Not only for Greenspring, but within the industry. I mean, we still are holding some of the highest occupancies throughout the industry, so it's just a really mm-hmm. great place to be.
So I have, now when we were talking about apartments, I'm just remembering a rumor I heard maybe like 3 or 4 months ago. So maybe you can do a on-the-spot Mythbuster right now.
Oh,
so
hope so.
I forget who told me. It was a resident that told me that they were potentially going to start to help sales, was going to merge certain apartments together to make, I guess, one big apartment, like studio apartments to merge like two studio apartments to make one big apartment. Is that true? Or
they're called customized two bedrooms. And that is something that we are doing. Mm-hmm. We actually have two in the works right now. So we are taking, a one bedroom or two one bedrooms and putting them together, or two one bedrooms with dens and putting them mm-hmm. together. It helps our apartment mix. Mm-hmm. We know folks coming in, we still have a great population of folks out there that want larger apartments, things over 1800 square feet. Mm-hmm. So this gives us an opportunity to kind of dwindle down some of our smaller apartment homes and make them into mm-hmm. these luxury customized two bedroom homes. So we actually have two of them that we're working on right now. One's probably going to come online middle of July. The other one's probably going to come online closer to the end of the year. But it's a great opportunity. And so what I would say is that, you know, if you're in a one bedroom and you're living next to a one bedroom that just came open mm-hmm. and you're thinking, hey, I would love for sales to bring those two apartments together, we'll move you.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, if you want a new apartment and you're living next to an apartment that's available and you think that it would be something that we could combine, come talk to the sales office, because mm-hmm. we have moved residents so that we can combine two apartments.
All right.
So That is not, that is, hopefully that I've busted the myth.
You've busted the myth. Myth buster. Okay. Add that to your resume. So I have another question for you. Yeah. So I was talking with a resident here, and, you know, I always joke, you know, when I retire, you know, I'm going to move in somewhere like Green Spring and stuff. Yeah. And so we were talking. Can you kind of explain what are the rules of like who can live together? And I say that in a sense of like, you know, we say we want residents to market to their friends and stuff. Yeah. But, you know, some people, you know, they live with their sister or they live with their brothers. You know, is there rules and regulations on like with Green Spring, like who can like join together to live together? Or is it kind of just.
So that's a long answer to that question. I'll give you kind of the short abbreviated
one. All right.
Got to be 62 or older to live here. Mm-hmm. And anyone who moves into our community has to go through the approval process. Mm-hmm. So if you are a, you know, brother and you want to live together, that's fine. Mm-hmm. Two people to an apartment. If you're a sister and a brother, your cousins, your mm-hmm. friends, that's fine. Both parties have to meet our approval processes. But yeah, you can absolutely move in, you know, with a loved one or with a family member. You know, once again, as long mm-hmm. as it doesn't exceed two people, and as long as both individuals meet the qualifications, it's
good. Is there a reason why there's only allowed two people?
So based on our apartment structure, that's the guidelines that mm-hmm. the state has set forth that, you know, you can only have two people max living in an apartment mm-hmm. That has two bedrooms. We don't go up to three bedrooms. Mm-hmm. So basically the rhyme is a bed for head. So, you know, you got two bedrooms, two people can be in the bedroom. Mm-hmm. You got two spaces, two people can be in the space. So that's just, we're governed by the state. So on that end.
All right, cool. Yeah. Thanks for answering my question.
Yeah, no problem.
You have anything else you want to ask? Answer?
No. you know, if you ever have a desire as a resident to come out and mm-hmm. help us with our events, we're always making a plug to get new resident ambassadors. You know, come see our office, come see Maya. Mm-hmm. We got a lot of great events coming up. And so just once again, thanks for all the support and the help that we already received. But always looking for more.
Can you tell us real quick, what does a resident ambassador do?
Yeah, so they help us out with the events, whether you're a greeter, table host, hall monitor, mm-hmm. show your apartment. It's just a great opportunity to meet some of our future residents and really share your story about why you moved to Green Spring. We always tell folks that you know, the best salespeople we have at our community are our residents. Mm-hmm. You know, they all know what it's like to live here, and they're the best representation of our community. So, anytime someone wants to come out and share their story, we're open to it.
Perfect. Yeah. Well, David, thanks for coming on.
Thanks.
The next time you're here, it will be April, and we'll be talking about Avengers and Game of Thrones
then.
All right. Thanks for coming on.